New York Islanders hockey is presented by Mount Sinai South Nassau in Oceanside. We find a way. The Isles will host the Seattle Kraken tonight in their first ever meeting. The Isles looking to finish up their 7-game homestand on a high note after a nice win just last night here over the Senators. Hello, everyone. Welcome inside UBS Arena at Belmont Park. I'm Shannon Hogan. Puck drop between the Islanders and the Seattle Kraken is coming your way in moments right here on MSG+. Both of these teams are on the second night of a back-to-back set, but the Islanders were able to win their game last night here at UBS Arena and are hoping to bring that energy into this matchup and come away with another coveted 2 points. Jordan Eberle seeing some of his old friends wearing blue and orange uniform. He is going to be wearing Seattle Kraken jersey. And speaking of old friends, we have an old friend up in the broadcast booth. Jigs McDonald is joining Butch Goring for tonight's call. Guys.
Shannon, thank you. Kind of ironic. I come back on Groundhog Day year after year. Well, not year after year, but it is Groundhog Day, and nice to be back with you.
Yeah, you know what, Jakes? It is really nice to be back with you, but you're right. Groundhog Day. I was with you in the 70s with the Kings. I was with the Islanders. Okay. You were with the Islanders. I was with you again in the year 2000, and here I am again with you in the 2020. But it's always a pleasure to be surrounded by a Hall of Famer.
Got me propped up, and we're ready to go. You know, the old adage, being old, Defense wins. Well, last night, offense from the defense really helped the Islanders to that victory over Ottawa.
Yeah, it was a great display by the Islander defense to get involved in the offensive side of the game. And, you know, they're 30th in the league in points from the defense. So this was a good change for them. And they need this going forward with the rest of the season. But that was Ryan Pulock. Good to have him and his big shot. Zdeno Chara getting more invited offensively. Got the puck towards net, a goal. And, of course, Scott Mayfield, an outstanding game, a great pass to Barzal. That led to a goal. And then another unbelievable play to his defense partner, Mayfield to Pelech. And what a play that was. So that's something that the Islanders haven't done on a regular basis, Jakes. They need to continue to do that. I mean, if they're going to win a lot of hockey games, they certainly need their offense from their defense.
From my standpoint, offense centers around specialty teams. The power play hasn't been that good, but a second effort last night really kicked it into gear.
You know what? You always talk about the entry of the power play, and that's an important because it gets you into the offensive zone and allows you to set up your plays or at least try to set them up and get a little momentum going. Well, this is a proof that it doesn't always have to work that way. All you need is the speedy Anthony Beauvillier. He comes up the middle, chips it in, chases it, and wins the battle. And then the Islanders get control, and now they go to work, and eventually they get the puck back to the point for the shot from the point, and all got four guys, Brock Nelson, Anthony Beauvillier, and who should finish it off but the guy that started it, Anthony Beauvillier. So yes, the power play has a lot of different elements involved in it, and there's a lot of different sneaky plays and great plays, but sometimes it's good old-fashioned hockey.
And old-fashioned hockey returns tonight in the form or person of Jordan Eberle. 5 seasons with the New York Islanders, a bit of a streaky player.
He is very streaky, but he's a great teammate, and he has an awful lot of friends on the other side of the red line now. But this is a guy that came to play, had a lot of chances to score goals, played hard, not only in the offensive zone, but certainly in the defensive zone. And he found his scoring touch early on with Seattle, scoring goals on and up in the toy department, around the front of the net. He's a very creative individual, Jigs, and when he gets it going, there's no better scorer in the league. He certainly has the touch. Now he's in a bit of a dry spell, which is something that followed him from Edmonton to the Islanders. So when he's hot, he's really hot. And when he's not, well, he's not.
When you come back for the first time against your old team, the guys used to put money on the board. Will there be money on the board for him to get a goal?
I would absolutely think so. I mean, this is an old-fashioned way of, you know, kind of exciting your teammate. And it's a lot of pressure from within the dressing room. Come on, Jordan, put some money up. Perhaps you'll score tonight. Win a lot of money then.
20 games without a goal for Jordan Eberle. We'll see what happens as the Islanders and the Kraken meet here. The Islanders finishing up the 7-game homestand. There's some pretty goals over that streak. 3 wins, 3 losses. And tonight they look for their 10th home ice victory of the season. Which one of the guys in the dark blue uniforms will get the game winner? Islanders and Kraken next. For the first time, they'll meet again later this month out in Seattle. Semyon Varlamov gets the start for the Islanders. Record of 3-8-1 on the season, a 9.15 goals against average. And the high-priced Philip Grubauer will be in the nets for Seattle tonight. 11-17-4. A little different from his numbers a year ago. The goaltending matchup brought to you by Audi. Visit your Tri-State Audi dealer today and get behind the wheel of the Audi model you have always wanted. Kelly Sutherland and Derek Danson, the referees for tonight's game. And immediately, the Islanders dump it into the Seattle zone to our right and get in on the forecheck. Seattle off a loss in Boston last night. They've won five road games this season. The Islanders looking for their fourth win in the seven-game homestand. And that's Eberle up the right side into the center ice area, where McCann and Johansson join him and dump deep into the Islanders zone. Back to the point. It's done with a long shot that didn't get through. You're still here, right?
Well, you know what? I'm letting you shake the rust off, Jiggs.
You've got all night for that, my friend. Quick change on D for the Islanders. Now the forward line starts to make some changes as well. Beauvillier unable to knock the puck loose, and the Krakener across the line. A severing feed knocked away from Yanni Gord. Gord, the former Tampa Bay Lightning, always a thorn in the side of the Islanders.
Brings a couple of cups with him too, and experience. Good hard worker for these Kraken, and that's the way they play. They'll try to outwork you if they can't out-talent you.
A team built along the lines of the play during his Hall of Fame career, general manager Ron Francis, I would say. Would you agree?
Absolutely. A lot of patience in this organization.
Loose puck in front of the Islander goal, a jam up the net off the moorings, and play call.
Well, it's important for Farley to get off to a good start, and the Islanders themselves. They've given up early first goals on about five or six games in a row, and they've been chasing basically all year. They've only led nine times after the first period in this entire first half, Jake. So, I mean, that's a tough way to play the game.
Indeed, night after night, catch up hockey. Seattle got off to a two-goal deficit last night in Boston and then rallied for a 3-2 loss. Some feel that Boston took the foot off the pedal a little.
You don't want to do that with these guys. They, you know, the one thing they're trying to do is impress their general manager and the coach that they're workers.
The Islanders with the forward line of Lee, Barzal, and Bailey out there right now. Barzal banked one up the right-wing boards. Anders Lee chasing it back. Working on Luzon, the former Boston Bruin defenseman. Bailey gets it back to the line. Pulock is here on the right point. Andy Green on the left point, and it's Green going back deep into his own zone as both teams start to make some player changes.
There with Ryan Pulock getting back, teamed up with Andy Green. Barry Trotz wanting to keep the other four defensemen together.
Now the Islanders complete their change as the puck is dumped in deep. Wallstrom in on the forecheck, forcing the defenseman Adam Larson to turn it up the right side. Larson, the former Devil, who ended up in Edmonton, and then Seattle. He's one of the names being mentioned prominently if they were to make some trades before the deadline or at the deadline. Get some draft picks for the future of the Seattle team.
Yeah, there'll probably be four to six people, a couple of veteran defensemen, Giordano, Larson. The Fleury brothers, I suspect, will stay.
And they were teamed up momentarily on that Seattle defense. Kraken trying to come up the left side. Here's Jared McCann over center ice. Eberle with him on the left side. The pass broken up, and the Islanders take over.
Great job on the back check by Matt Martin.
Cizikas said on the forecheck, couldn't get it back to Clutterbuck, who had dumped it in originally, and Matt Martin comes back quickly on McCann. McCann unable to drop it off for Eberle, and here the Islanders over center ice. Clutterbuck on his off wing, centers one, that just went wide. The defense gets in quickly on the forecheck. That was Pelech in deep, and now Seattle in the midst of the change, slowing things up a little.
Yeah, Adam Pellick's been a lot more aggressive over the last few games, and that's a good sign. He's a terrific skater.
Fifth shot on goal for Seattle in this opening period. The Islanders move to center. Brock Nelson checked at the Seattle line. The knocked off balance, and on the play for the Islanders, and unable to complete. The whole thing was Paul Mary. Grubauer making his first major effort of the night.
He thought it was offside, Jiggs. He hesitated and not sure. They certainly would have checked it as the puck came through the middle of the ice with Brock Nelson and Paul Murray. Just kind of hesitated a little bit. He had to get past the on-rushing defenseman, Vince Dutton. Well, there's a guy that's looking for a goal, working hard. You know he's got a lot of pride. He hasn't scored in quite a while. Hasn't been much of an offensive threat out there. He plays hard, Jiggs, and you know guys that play hard and are used to scoring, you know they feel the pressure.
Back-to-back games, probably didn't get much of a chance to celebrate his 31st birthday yesterday.
Well, at least the team won, and that's the most important thing.
Now some time off after tonight as the All-Star break comes up. Seattle trying to get an odd man rush going. 3-on-2 at the Allender line. But unable to complete the play was Danskoy. Daly, nice pass to the left side. Lee put it in front, couldn't get it to Barzal in time, and the Kraken come to center ice.
Now Barzal was covered. Anders would have been better served to shoot that puck, maybe a rebound.
Ryan Donato gave it up for Seattle. Their captain, Mike Giordano, reorganizing the play inside his own zone. No Islander fans not happy when Everly was selected off the Islander roster by the Seattle team. I think probably the same in Calgary with Mark Giordano, their captain for many, many seasons. Selected by the Kraken.
Close to a hold right there by Sheehan on Pajot.
Down offside and 14:47 is the time remaining in this opening period. The Islanders still not credited with a shot on goal.
Not sure why that whistle took place. There wasn't any kind of a delayed offside, but be that as it may, face off at center ice, Jiggs, and we're looking at the big Z-man, and he's really upped his game and talked about him getting more involved offensively and creating more opportunities for his teammates.
With Tom Brady making his announcement final yesterday, the Big Z, now the oldest participating athlete in any sport.
You're the oldest play-by-play guy in
any
sport.
I knew that was coming.
Well, you set me up.
Yeah, and you knocked it down. You could have just left it alone, but no. Here's an icing call coming.
Good pace out there for both teams, and good sign for the Islanders, Jiggs. They didn't give up a goal in the first 5 minutes, so that's a plus. I mean, they have struggled coming out of the gate, and they really, over the last half dozen games or so, their game has got better and better as the game has progressed.
And a look at Dave Haxtell back of that Seattle bench. 53-year-old. Sixth shot on goal for Seattle in this opening period.
Opening faceoff or faceoff win for the Kraken. Gord, with the good move.
Zach Parise played it up the far boards, and the Islanders completing their player changes now. So Appleton tips it back into his own zone, and that's Vince Dunn playing it cross ice. Dunn and Lazan, the defense combination for the Kraken.
Jiggs, you would have watched his father play, Zach's father, with the Islanders, I presume.
No, JP wasn't here when I arrived, but I did, yes, prior to me entering the broadcast booth here, so when he was here and I was down south, so to speak.
Plays just like his dad, plays hard every shift.
The Islanders with a long shot, gloved by Grubauer, and you soon drop it off. The Kraken into the center ice area.
Boy, nobody can get much of a forecheck going. Both teams moving the puck extremely quick. Good support from one another. And there's another quick exit for the Islanders.
Al Palmieri plays it off the right wing boards. Chases it in against Hayden Fleury. The two Fleury brothers teamed up on their defense. Hayden is 25 and Kale is 22 years old. And play called here with 12:51 remaining in the opening period.
Everly not happy with that icing call. He claims that he deflected it, and it looked like he did actually. But now they're going to check it out. No, linesman says no, he missed it. And he can't go to a replay for that either, Jiggs.
No, not one of them.
See who So go to the left side. Bailey takes faceoffs. Former center in junior hockey and played center also at the pro level.
That was McCann on the draw for Seattle, and big Zdeno Chara back for the Islanders. He and Noah Dobson, the defense combination. Chara looks up the left side. Got it on and off the stick of Lee, and here's Bailey centering. Lee left it. Barcel played it back to the point. Chara's shot just went wide. Noah Dobson pinching in on the right wing boards. Anders Lee is pinned against the boards. The battle for it ensuing in the near corner. They let them play on. Back to the point for Chara. Long shot. Right on. A big rebound out of the reach of Bailey. But Bailey got a bit of a fan, and it's going to be called. First penalty of the game, setting up a Seattle power play.
That was Barzal in the middle of the ice. And didn't look like much, Jakes.
Odd man advantage coming up for the Seattle Kraken as Bailey takes a bench, and we'll be right back. '76 goals, 93 assists, 272 regular season points, and a nice tribute from these Islander fans, many of them disappointed when he was selected in the entry draft, or at least the expansion draft, by the Seattle Kraken. Came here in a trade from the Edmonton Oilers. Postseason, a little more productive on an average basis than his regular season, Butch.
And a tremendously warm welcome for Jordan Eberle, and he was all smiles, and he was a good teammate for all of his teammates. They all liked him a whole lot, and he's moved on now. But I'm impressed with the appreciation from the fans for the contributions that Jordan provided for this New York Islander team.
We saw a graphic earlier just how productive he was in the early stages this season for Seattle, and how things have dried up for him. 20 games without a goal. Had three glorious chances last night in the game at Boston, and it just wouldn't go for him.
Well, he's got someone on the other side of the red line that's feeling the exact same pain. It's a Kyle.
Strange game, isn't it?
It really is, Jiggs. It can come and go, and when it's there and you're hot and you're having fun, life is so much better.
See, the Bailey is off for tripping. Kraken setting up at the blue line. Giordano has it again at the left point. Cross ice feed. Quick shot is high and wide off the can stick, and they'll recover it center ice.
Yeah, you want to try and pick the corner, but at the same time, if you miss the net, there's a good chance that it might go right out, and that's exactly what happened.
Here's Eberle across the Islander blue line. Giordano covering the point. Played it cross ice. McCann unable to find a teammate. Giordano just outside the blue line, a delayed offside, and the Islanders recover and dump it down.
Good aggressive penalty killing by the Islanders, getting in the shooting lanes. Critical part of penalty killing, not letting that puck get to the net.
Islanders' 10th best penalty killing in the entire league at the moment. And they've broken up a Seattle attempt and dump it to the line. Recovered, and Pageau bounces it off the end boards and goes in on the forecheck. Seattle able to recover. They come through center ice. The feed to Ryan Donato.
Oh boy.
And then giveaway intercepted, and here's Pageau across the line. Trying to cut to the net and couldn't get around Vince Dunn. Pageau wheels it back to his own line for Charles to Scott Mayfield. Hard around the boards into the zone, and the teams are at full strength again.
Tough pass by Donskoy, boy, right onto the stick of Pageau.
Yeah.
Lucky Dunn is a good skater, as Pageau would have had a breakaway, but good job of penalty killing, Jakes. They never had a tough chance there. There's the PK, and you talk about putting pressure along the boards on the puck carrier. You don't want to give him a whole lot of time. You see him bobbling it all, Jakes. You try to get on him. What the Islanders are doing really well there is they're anticipating where that puck is going. That one comes offside and allows the Islanders to change. But good job by the Islanders there, as I said, in reacting to what was happening.
Now Bailey steps out of the box as The goaltender, Varlamov, smothered the puck and held on. Islanders nothing, Seattle nothing. 10 minutes gone in the opening period.
Now, talk about a tough coaching job, Dave Hextall, as he studies his lineup. I'm not sure he knows his lineup. When you get 20 players coming from 20 different teams, Jakes, you're trying to build a hockey team. You're trying to find chemistry amongst not only yourself, but amongst your players. That's about as tough a job as you can have, and Dave Hextall's got his team playing pretty well. But, man, oh, man, that is an incredibly difficult task when so many different coaches that all these players have had, and now they got a different one again.
Well, they got a lesson on how difficult it is. Got Philadelphia into third place in the division.
Yep.
And 31 games into the next season. Bye-bye.
And the life of a coach.
Yep.
Don't buy a house, buy a trailer.
Or make sure if you buy a house, it's on wheels, right?
Yes.
Islanders into that Seattle zone. Barzal dropped it back. Green can't get it to that. Here's Bailey covering the right point, and the puck bounced off his stick. Bailey making the connection with Green, and then right back. Andy Green up the middle. And the Islanders unable to recover in the Seattle zone as Lee, Barzal, and Bailey are the forward line at the moment. Bailey got the puck in. And Lazar Larson, rather, will get it out of there.
It's going up and over.
Yep. Into the protected netting. So play called with 9:06 left in this first period.
Well, the Kraken aren't giving the Islanders a whole lot of opportunities coming through the neutral zone. Want to try and slow them down, and Dave Hextall, I'm sure one of his most important elements in coaching is to try and teach as many of these, particularly the young guys, about play away from the puck. We know we hear Barry Trotz talk about it with his young players all the time. You know, learn to play both ends of the rink efficiently. End of the day, good defense will win you championships.
Brock Nelson got over the line and was checked, and the Islanders have to send Chara back for it. Beauvillier tips it to Palmieri. 3, now 4. Kraken are back. Well, they're on you in a hurry. Palmieri tips it around the boards. Beauvillier can't get it to a teammate. And Seattle over center with a dump in here. Noah Dobson left it in the far corner. Johansson had it knocked away, and the puck will end up deep in the Seattle zone. A race for it. Peyton Fleury got back in time on that Seattle defense.
Yeah, good reverse there by Fleury.
Here's Eberle rounding the Islanders' goal. Puts one out in front, off the stick of Tsitsikas, and all the way back into the Seattle end of the ice.
Peyton Fleury, a former first-round pick, I believe, Jakes. And
yeah, the Carolina Hurricanes. Then ended up in Anaheim before being selected by Seattle. Hayden won a Calder Cup, did he not, with Charlotte?
With Charlotte, yeah. You know, I love people on my team that win.
And the Islanders called for an icing here. New York Islanders with just one shot on goal through 12 minutes and 16 seconds of this opening period.
Yeah, they really haven't had, as we look at the Fleury brothers, it must be fun to have your brother playing on the team. Maybe not fun if he's sitting in the stands, but certainly fun. And then think about it, playing as your partner. I mean, you think you're on the same page there, right? I mean, the DNA is pretty strong, and an opportunity for his brother to establish his career. Hayden has pretty much set himself in as an NHLer.
Three sets of brothers playing on NHL teams this season. The Jones brothers, Chicago. The two that we're watching here tonight, and there is a third. There's a little bit of trivia for you.
Oh, now you're taking over trivia, huh?
No, I'm just throwing it out.
Eric Hornick's not here, and he's usually in trouble.
The Islanders trying to get out of their own end of the ice, but a good forecheck thrown up by the Kraken. The puck centered in front, and the shot dribbled off the stick. Well, Pellick and right to the catching glove. Semyon Varlamov.
Both these teams played last night, Jake, so there's no real advantage. I mean, if there's an advantage, it should be the Islanders. They didn't have to travel where the Kraken did. But certainly, so far at this point in time, with 7 minutes to go, Seattle has a little bit of an edge. They seem to have a little more jump in their game.
Seattle didn't get into Manhattan, where they stayed last night, until after 2 a.m. By the time they got to the airport in Bedford, and were de-iced, And we're getting an icing call here. Then flew into Newark, bussed into the city. It was well after 2 before they checked in.
Sometimes, Jigs, as a hockey player, you can get too much sleep. You know, then you're a little groggy. Back in the 70s, we didn't get all that much sleep.
Okay. You're still working on the third set of brothers, aren't you?
Yeah.
Couple of radishes playing in Tampa.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
I did not know that.
Some broadcasters don't get much sleep either. Even at this age. Nothing, nothing. Islanders and the Seattle Kraken meeting for the first time ever.
Yeah, not a lot of offense from either team. Zone time, offensive zone time. Seattle has a little edge there, but overall there's not much going on. And what the Islanders are not doing very well is when they're chipping it in, Jigs, they're not putting it in places where they can get it back. There's not a whole lot of retrieval.
Eberle fed it across into the center ice area off the canned stick and recovered by Anders Lee. Gave it to Bailey. Barzal opened on the right side. They can't get the puck to him, and there's Eberle. Jordan Eberle moves it into the center ice area. Marcus Johansson with a dump in. The Islanders dump it right back out again off Bailey's stick. Now New York starting to make some player changes. Hayden Fleury played across ice, and the play was broken up. Brock Nelson waiting for some help. Went through a screen, and a big stop made by Grubauer. His first major test of this opening period. Islanders, Mayfield knocked it down at the line, dumped it in. Seattle able to come up with the puck again. It's Hayden Fleury playing it to his brother. Hale gets it into the Islanders zone, and now it comes back toward the right point. Taken there by Yanni Gourde. He gets checked, and they have to go all the way back. Just over 5 minutes to play, as you see, in the opening period. We're at the UBS Arena this Wednesday night. Nothing, nothing, Islanders and Kraken, and the play called on an offside.
Did you know right now you could still bet on any player to score a goal on FanDuel Sportsbook? Make every moment more and get in on the action now with FanDuel.
Well, Jigs, you mentioned the Islanders haven't had many opportunities towards the net, but good play by Brock Nelson. So good with the hand-eye coordination. Says, oh, well, guys are going to that. Let me throw it in that direction. And Grubauer makes a nice flipper save on the right-hand side. I think he got a pretty good look at it. Not much going on offensively for the Islanders.
Andy Green with a shot that just went wide. Pulak covering the right point. Puts one in front. Zekas playing it around the boards. Overcame Clutterbuck. Pulak beat it to the far corner. Zekas taps it back in the net. Clutterbuck and Martin working on behalf of the New York Islanders. Yanni Gourde has sprung loose here on the left side and flips one high. And it'll bounce into the Islanders' zone for Green. Now to Noah Dobson. Boy, that went off Clutterbuck's right hand, and he is shaking that on his way back to the bench. That's done.
Not sure if Giordano didn't get him a little two-hander there, Jigs, rather than the puck.
He will be right into the big New York Islander logo, the chest protector. And it's still Islanders nothing, Seattle nothing. Jordan McCann centering this top forward line for Seattle with Eberle on one side and Johansson on the other. McCann, first pick of the Vancouver Canucks back in 2014. Well-traveled, having played in Florida. Was with Pittsburgh when he was selected by Seattle in their expansion draft. Kraken trying to get set up. Eberle feeds it to the line. Giordano with a shot. Stick save, and the rebound goes to the far corner. Parisi took the man. The Islanders take the puck and just barely get it out of the zone. On they come. Pageau over the line. Wahlstrom with a shot. Turned aside. Zach Parisi. Wahlstrom back in the net. Accepts the pass. Look to the point, then reverses it. Wahlstrom to the front of the net. The centering pass went wide off his stick in a hurry. Wahlstrom centered. Nobody there in the dark uniform. Oliver Wahlstrom had it knocked away. Well, it's dumped down into the Islanders' zone by Johansson. Kraken got in quickly. The Islanders able to recover. Pellick on the end boards. What a battle for control of it. And Seattle comes up, beating it to Dunn at the left point. Crossite's long shot turned aside as Dunn moved it quickly for Lazon. And now the Islanders break through the center ice area. Drop pass. Maybe one too many passes.
Right idea, but Dobson was right in the middle of the ice. I mean, not a bad chance to. He had Barzal driving towards the net. I mean, it was a good thought, but it was a better decision there for me.
Got to shoot the puck, make something happen. The Islanders are going to be called for icing with 2:32 left in the opening period. New York now with three shots on goal. Only one fairly decent scoring attempt.
Take another look at this play here. Is a took Pellick about four whacks to be able to get that play. And Dobson just, Walsom just throws it towards the net there, looking for a play off the pad, Jakes. But Parise was driving towards the net, but then they had another opportunity where Dobson was right down the middle of the lane.
Saw the note on Wahlstrom. Goal last night and the game before.
And he's got a little bit of a streak going. He's a goal scorer. I mean, I don't think anybody denies that fact that he has the potential. He's a tremendous shot.
Great release, right?
Yeah, he really does. It's hard and he, you know, has a shooter's mentality.
There's a shot off the far side right into the catching glove. A big windup in the play by Wennberg for Seattle.
Well, the Islanders have done a good job in the turnovers that they've created in keeping the shooting lane wide open for the goaltender Varlamov to be able to snag it. I mean, there's no one in front of the net. Look at that. I mean, you know, you shouldn't score from there, and they didn't. So Varlamov will tell you, I'm a pretty good goaltender when I get those looks all game.
Varlamov with a 9.15 goals against average or save percentage. Goals against 2.61 at the start of tonight's game.
Yeah, those aren't the numbers he wants. He wants to be about 10 points higher in that save percentage and drop that goals against average.
And the guy at the other end could say the same. I mean, here's Grubauer with a goals against of 3.20 and a paycheck of close to $6 million a year.
He needs a little more help, though.
Well, yeah, not the same team in front of him as he's had in the past.
No, when you have the Avalanche in front of you and you're going to get a lot more goals, you're going to have a lot more wins, and you're going to spend less time in your zone, Jinks, when you have a great offensive team. So, but you know what? His bank account is being padded rather neatly to face a few more shots.
Were you, like most fans, surprised that he made the deal to go to Seattle?
No, not at all.
Why? Why would you're with a team that has a chance to contend for the Stanley Cup?
Well, my first guess would be they didn't offer him the same kind of money.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Stanley Cups for me, and this is hard for me to say, Jakes, are more important than money.
Now, wait a minute. The Islanders trying to get a chance set up here. Stanley Cups are more important than money. Well, I thought Grubauer had a chance to win a Stanley Cup, but maybe not. There's a quick shot turned aside by Grubauer. The Islanders trying to make a late flurry here. We're into the final minute of the opening period on home ice. Kulak sets up back of the net.
Good reverse there, but that's supposed to be a call reverse. Adam Pellick didn't expect it. Ryan Pulock thought he would, but supposed to be talking to one another. It's all about communication, and there wasn't any there.
And Wahlstrom had to turn back. Now it's played up the left wing boards, went off Parisi's stick. Zach Parisi knocked down, and Everly takes control. Dumped it around behind his own net. Lazon just clears it out into the center ice area. The Islanders set up shot. Pageau with a feed that's out of the reach of Parisi. Can get over the line. Everly reaching for a loose puck. Controlled by the Islanders. 6 seconds left. And on the right side here, it's Parisi trying to drive around Fleury as they went back to the net. And the horn sounds, ending a scoreless 20 minutes.
Yeah, and there wasn't a lot of offense from either side, as I mentioned early on, especially the first 15 minutes. There was a little more time in the defensive zone than the Islanders needed to spend, but I thought as the period started to wear down, Jiggs, they found their legs. They were spending more time. They were creating a little more ruckus in front of that net. So, again, as I said to you, the first 5 minutes, they didn't get scored on at all, Jiggs, and that's a big improvement. They're a very confident group as this game progresses, so I like the way things went for them in the first period.
Third game in four nights for both these teams, and then, of course, the All-Star break lies ahead. Stay tuned for the first period intermission. Intermission report brought to you by your local Honda dealers. And you see, Jordan Eberle is due to join Shannon Hogan. Butch will tear apart the opening period of tonight's game between the New York Islanders and the Seattle Kraken. All that coming to you from the UBS Arena, where the Islanders and the Seattle Kraken are nothing-nothing. Let's hear from Jordan Eberle when we come back from this beautiful new facility. Near capacity crowd again tonight, but neither team able to score during the first 20 minutes of this game.
Back here on the Honda Intermission Report, Islanders and Seattle Kraken, the first time these two teams have ever met in franchise history. Also, the first time the Islanders are getting the opportunity to play against their former teammate, Jordan Eberle. Jordan, it probably has to be a little surreal for you to be playing here at UBS Arena against your former team. What was it like that first period?
Yeah, it was a little different, obviously, playing against a lot of guys who are your friends on the other team. That being said, I've been traded before and gone back, but this is a little different. This bad being that I've never played in this arena, so it doesn't feel, you know, like the Coliseum and the runs we had the last few years. So, but all in all, it was a great ovation by the fans there, and it's always nice to come back and see some old friends.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of Eberle jerseys in the house, not just Islanders jerseys, but also Seattle Kraken jerseys. What has it been like for you being a part of starting a new franchise and all the excitement surrounding your team in Seattle?
Yeah, it's been a unique experience. I mean, not many guys get to go through starting a brand new franchise, but you know, we've made Seattle our home, my wife and my child, and you know, we've loved it so far. So it's all about trying to just continue to build wins, and as of late, we've really started to play well and found our identity. So we knew it was going to take some time, and I'm sure it will.
What's your take on the first period action so far? What would you like to see from your team moving forward?
I think we just got to continue what we're doing. I like the way we're playing. We're limiting their chances, and we're creating some of our own. So, you know, obviously I know this Islander team, they're very stingy. They're not going to give up a lot, but, you know, we got to find a way to get one when we can.
All right, Jordan, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks.
We're going to take a quick break here on the Honda Intermission Report. When we return, Butch Goring is breaking down the first period action between the Isles and the Kraken. Report rolls on from UBS Arena, 0-0 after 20 minutes of play. Islanders and Kraken, the first ever meeting between these two teams. Shannon Hogan and Butch Goring joining you on our intermission report. Butchie, what did you see out of that first 20 minutes from both those teams?
Well, there wasn't a lot happening in either end of the building, as far as I'm concerned. The goaltenders weren't overly worked. There were a couple of okay saves, but, you know, for the Islanders, a little bit of a slow start, but then they started to pick up some speed. But Shannon, what I'd like to see is a little bit more offensive opportunities for them, and there's a couple ways you can do that. You know, and we highlighted it in the opening and in the pregame, is one is the defense has got to activate. They've got to make a better effort to get involved in the play. I mean, the game the other night, we saw all kinds of opportunities. We saw Alan Pellick get involved in some good plays by Mayfield. So that's one of the ways. The other thing is on the forecheck, and I talk about it early in the first period. When you do chip that puck and put it in some place where you have a chance to get it, or at least have a one-on-one battle, they're just aimlessly dumping it in. And I've talked about how easily the Seattle Kraken were able to get out. Well, that's because the dumping was not too good. So they got to get better in those two areas.
All right, Butchie, rest up. You got a big game, rest of the game going. So take a little break before you and Jiggs get ready to drop that puck and call that rest of this game in the second period action. We're taking a break on the Honda Intermission Report, coming to you live from UBS Arena. Isles and Kraken scoreless after one. Report rolls on from UBS Arena. Islanders and Kraken neither have scored a goal through 20 minutes of play. Isles Nation celebrates their historic 50th anniversary, and it's coming up next season. Season ticket members will get special access to offers and experiences celebrating this wonderful milestone. To place your deposit today and to secure your membership for next season, visit NewYorkIslanders.com/deposit. Triple Health Ice Center is the coolest place on Long Island. It offers something for everyone, including public skate sessions, learn to skate and learn to play, youth house leagues, hockey clinics, adult leagues, and so much more. Visit www.northwellhealthicecenter.com for details. Northwell Health Ice Center, it's the coolest place on Long Island. Now it's time to check the line, presented by FanDuel Sportsbook. Make every moment more. The ice is ready and the players are just about ready to skate out onto the ice for the drop of the puck in the second period action. We're heading to break when we return. Jigs and Butch take over on the other side.
In Oceanside, we find a way. Islanders nothing, Kraken nothing. How about some trivia, the Cadillac trivia for the night? Take a look. Reach your answer to hashtag Cadillac trivia. Harry O. Sunning himself in Florida these days. But who scored the first goal in Kraken history? I think he's playing tonight.
You know what I do know, Jakes? It's his first year with the team.
Bingo. They have retired a jersey number in Seattle already, but not his. You know they retired number 32 because they're the 32nd team in the league?
Uh-huh.
Anders Lee, Islander captain, has an old Notre Dame teammate on the other side of the ice tonight, Riley Sheehan. Riley, 30 years of age. Riley was a first-round draft pick.
Good skater, Jakes. That's one thing I know about watching him play. Been with a couple different teams.
Yeah, Detroit took him in the first round of the 2010 draft. He was there for 4 years, Florida for a while. Then in Buffalo, signed there as a free agent. Seattle is a free agent, too. The Kraken dumping the puck down into the Islander end. That's Eberle. Turned it around the boards to the far point. The zone open here on the right. They didn't get it to him. And Clutterbuck worked it up the boards, but not out of the zone. Centered right out in front and steered aside by Pellick. Now hoisted out to center by Clutterbuck. Field goal attempt high and ended up inside the Seattle zone. Quickly up the left side with a shot that is on target and turned aside by Varlama. Seattle with their 11th shot on goal in the opening period. Now have 12, I would say. The Islanders had a little flurry going late in that opening period. Now Palmieri plays it deeper. The Islanders.
That was cross-checking in front,
wasn't it?
Boy, look.
We've had only the one penalty call in the game tonight, and now Seattle dumping it down into the Islander zone.
That was Fleury that put a pretty good cross check on Palmieri as he was in the slot area. If it wasn't cross checking, it was interference. Good job by Chara staying up on the Kraken.
And Beauvillier lugged it across the line and into the near corner. Barzal going back in the net, knocked away. Out at the point. Long shot through a screen, not skittered wide. Well, the Kraken, Yanni Gord reorganizes things. Mentioned earlier how Gord has always been a pain in the backside to these New York Islanders when he was with Tampa. 9 points in something like 7 or 8 games. He reminds me of a guy sitting to my right. Just a tough guy to play against. Always on the puck. So you're looking to your right? No, not your right. My right. Islanders up 2-on-2. Crisscross lead to the right. Barzal had nobody to give it to, and here's a break. Barzal takes his man down. Well, the Kraken just cannot make it happen. That was Ryan Donato, who had a man open for a moment but mishandled the puck, and now the Islanders shorthanded for the second time tonight.
Now Barzal takes a penalty, and it's not a good penalty, but it started off really poorly for him. I mean, one thing that Matt's got to learn is that they're not going to give him the time and the space. The back checkers are going to come hard on him. They corralled him quickly, and then Donato, using his speed, keep going and forces Barzal, who was just trying to slow him down a little bit, puts the hook on him, and now the Kraken have a power play. And Barzal will be getting an earful from Barry Trotz because, I mean, that's one area that you've got to be a whole lot better at, and that's right at the blue line. Those are turnovers, and those are usually costly mistakes.
Eberle fed it back to the blue line. This is Pecan. Giordano works it down low. Giordano, the lone man back. Kind of a four-man up front, one-man back type of power play setup. McCann off the right wing boards. Back to McCann. To Giordano. Screen set up in front. Eberle twisting and turning, trying to get away. Giordano to McCann. Jordan McCann plays it down low at the icing line. Here's Johansson trying to get a man open. Now McCann with a shot off the stick. Off the glass as well, and right back to McCann. McCann fires, missed on the near side, and it rebounds off the boards all the way down.
Terrible play by McCann. He knows that Adam Pellick gave his stick, broke his stick, and then Cizikas didn't have his after he gave it to Pellick. You got to hit the net there. You gave the Islanders an opportunity to get four fresh bodies. So that's not a good play by the forward McCann, who's scored a lot of goals for this team, but still got to be better than that.
Seattle trying to get set up at the blue line. They're able to keep the puck in play. Donskoy. And Gord got it back to the line. Centered in front. Knocked away by Varlamov. Recovered by Gord. Yanni Gord. Little give and go here with Dunn. Gord in the right faceoff circle. And everything open on the left side and knocked away, but Gord is there to recover and then turned away from the puck after it bounced away from him. And the Islanders are going to get out of the zone. Back at full strength as Pageau fires one. Barzal out of the box, the net knocked off its moorings, and there'll be a penalty against the Kraken.
Yeah, that was a late hit on Barzal by Mike Dunn, and he'll go to the
Seattle penalty number 29, 2 minutes for roughing.
But watch Chara make this clearing play. Good long stick, and then recognizes he's got support in the middle of the ice, and that's a beautiful pass. That's experience, and he's got a whole lot of it. And then Barzal just goes right to the net. You know what? I'm not sure that was a great penalty. I think the Islanders got a break on it as Barzal goes to the net. Well, yeah, you know what? Did get that left arm up around the head area, didn't he? So perhaps that was a better penalty than I first thought. I'm getting soft on the referees.
Yeah, I noticed.
Yeah, trying to be objective.
And a roughing penalty at that.
Yes.
Roughing. So the Islanders with the man advantage in this power play is brought to you by your Tri-State Volkswagen dealers.
Kraken haven't been very good on the penalty kill as of late.
The Islanders in the neutral zone. Lee fed it across. Barzal's over the line. Now it comes back to the blue line. Barzal feeding it once more. Dobson shot through a screen, ricocheted in front. And down to the end boards with the Islanders able to control it. Pageau got it to the line. Dobson to the near corner, but away from Barzal. Lee to the far corner. Lee again to Barzal. Home man back is Dobson. Played to the icing line to Barzal, and he gave it up. Penalty killing of Blackwell is able to move it down into the Islander end of the ice.
Yeah, Barzal having a tough time handling the puck tonight. Well, he's a little bit more serious on that rush, isn't he?
Nice centering pass, and then the return failed to connect in front of that Seattle goal. Cross ice. Wallstrom shot. That missed. Dobson at the right point holds it in. Nobody in front at the moment. Now Dobson shot. They do get a man in front, screening the goaltender Grubauer, but it goes out of play with 39 seconds left in this power play.
Well, Islanders getting the puck a little bit more often to the net. Dobson has a terrific wrist shot. Fires out when it gets all the way through. Anders Lee is not able to find it. Barzal cross ice, and Dobson trying to get in on the backhand play there. So the Islanders really kind of like mixed up when they should shoot, as far as I'm concerned, Jigs, and when they should pass it.
A little bit of a hesitancy, isn't there? That extra second to think about what should I do, or a split second can cost. Here's Bailey at the left point. Got it back. Nice return feed with Pulock. Cross ice. No connection for the Islanders, and we're down to 15 seconds remaining in the power play.
Bailey was looking for Zach Parise, who was in front of the, just in front of the crease, looking for a quick deflection.
Now Pulock lets one go through a screen and under the pads of Grubauer.
A little pushing and shoving there, to, which is always after the goaltender makes a save if the defensive side thinks you're just a little too aggressive, Jakes. And Zach Parise was in front of that net. And not a bad power play for the Islanders, but again, not enough movement for me.
Well, the power play on home ice for the Islanders, operating at 18th best in the league. And Seattle's penalty killing, you see the numbers there. Power play goal against in 8 straight games and 2 in their last 8. And they have killed this one off. Butterbuck taking it back at the Seattle goal, gave it up. And the Islanders will chase it back. Adam Pellick. He's headed to the All-Star game. The rest of the squad, I'm sure, have plans of what they'll do for the break coming up. Islanders nothing, Kraken nothing. We're in the second period at the UBS Arena. In the midway point of the second period tonight.
Well, Jarrett McCann, and he's been the team leader pretty much for every point you can think of. His plus minus is actually pretty good when you have a team that's not winning a whole lot of hockey games. 18 goals, and he's been a good player playing with him. He, of course, Jordan Eberle and Marcus Johansson. Johansson used to play with the Washington Capitals, Jigs, and was really a force on their power play with Ovechkin and Backstrom.
Yeah, he was with the Caps, I think, around 7 years after being a first-round pick in 2009. Mentioning McCann, Vancouver drafted him in the opening round, first-round pick, right? Little, some travels in between before arriving in Seattle.
Yeah, maybe just some guys take a little longer than others to kind of find their game, and looks like he's found his game.
He was in Florida for a while, played well there to begin with, and then they shipped him off to Pittsburgh.
Well, you're not going to get the big ice time there when you have the two big dogs there at center.
Threw it up. Well, the Islanders end in their own zone at the moment. The Flurry brothers on defense. Long shot doesn't get through. Loose puck. Nice sliding save by the goaltender Barlamov. Andy Green, a little off balance, trying to move it up the boards, could not. Kraken don't have anybody open in front, so they feed the point. Hayden Flurry down low, and then a centering attempt comes all the way cross ice by Geeky. Geeky with it here on the right wing boards. Centered one that's broken up, and the Islanders have an odd man break. Beauvillier is over the line, but a shot put off the defenseman. Hayden Flurry.
That was late in the shift after they spent 30 seconds in their own zone. Blackwell with a great opportunity to put his team ahead a little bit, but Barlamov was strong there, aggressive, got the flipper down and made a real nice left pad save. Came out towards him, Jiggs. He didn't stay in his net and give him much to look at.
All right, held that ground, but now Blackwell, there's it down into the Islanders' zone. This will be right to the blue paint. Seattle in the middle of some changes, and the Islanders looking for the opening goal of the game. Mayfield worked it to center ice. Pageau fed Parise, who's dumped it around the boards. Back on it is McCann. His top line for Seattle trying to get out of the zone. Johansson lugs it out. Then fed across ice. McCann drop pass. Eberle shot. That went wide, and Parise can't clear the zone. But he gets a second attempt, and this time moves it up the right wing boards. That was deflected down into the Seattle end, so no icing call.
Did you mentioned early on, third game in 4 nights for both of these teams, and they're not as sharp as they might be. There, as I said, there hasn't been a lot of opportunities. Blackwell, that was a pretty good opportunity for him, but they've been few and far between, and the Islanders have had one in this whole period thus far.
Neither team will play again until a week from tonight as the puck bounces around at the Islanders' goal line, ends up back to the net.
Now that was Varlamov, gave the puck away, and every once in a while he does do that. He's not the best guy in the world with handling the puck in his own zone.
Now Bailey lugs it across the Seattle line. His shot went wide. Marcel trying to work it off the right wing boards. Held in by Lee, but recovered by Seattle. And cleared out. And through Green, so Varlamov went out of the net. Seattle in the middle of changes, and the Islanders trying to come out of the zone. The smooth skating here by Pulak. Had it, lost it, got it again. Gets it again. But the play stays onside, and Ryan Donato. That's Teddy Donato's boy out of Harvard University trying to center. His dad played in this league for some time. You can always tell a Harvard guy, can't you? You just can't tell him much.
I'm not going near that.
Goal line from an old broadcaster. Clutterbuck in after a loose puck. Ridden off it. So Donskoy will try to set things up for Seattle. Dale Fleury moved it to center into the Islander end, and an icing call against the Kraken with exactly 9 minutes left in the second period.
Well, I talked earlier on about the one really good chance that the Kraken had, and good support here and there, and Geeky's in front of the net and shot towards the net, and that's Blackwell, and you can see the aggressive move by Varlamov and taking away all the angle and staying in control. And
chance right there for the Islanders, but it's still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, that was Brock Nelson right off the faceoff and couldn't get the puck up in the air.
Chara has one deflected up into the protective netting. So with 8:43 left in the second period, we're still waiting for the opening goal of tonight's game.
Yesterday, Robin Herman passed away. And the reason that that name is important is because women all over the sports world, like me, owe her a huge, huge thank you for what she was able to do for women in sports. She broke the gender barrier in sports journalism, working for the New York Times and the Washington Post. She was the first female reporter to work in the Times sports department. And then back in 1975, 23 years old, you guys, she pushed and pushed. She wanted to make sure she had equal access inside the dressing room to interview the players after the games. And there was so much pushback in the 70s, 80s, and even 90s. She eventually was able to get in there to the NHL All-Star Game in 1975 in Montreal, and the rest is history. Rest in peace. She is really a pioneer for women in sports, and what is actually Women and Girls in Sports Day today on February 2nd. Guys?
Indeed, Shannon. When I first arrived here, you were here. Robin was the beat writer, the reporter, was the beat person for the New York Times covering the Islanders. Our condolences to her husband, Paul, daughter, Eva, son, Zachary. What a great lady.
Obviously a very persistent lady. So yeah, our condolences to the entire family.
And if I recall correctly, Lori Mifflin replaced her as the Times beat writer covering the Islanders. Good history there.
Varlamov not sure if he wants to freeze it, as the Islanders spent a little time in the zone, but nothing much going on there. It was offensive zone time for the Kraken. But no real shots on net. And the Islanders' 5-on-5 play in their own zone has been pretty good thus far.
Morgan Geeky in on the forecheck here, number 67 for Seattle. Former Carolina Hurricane draft. Now Fleury from the right point, that's the younger of the two brothers, Kale, and his shot was blocked. Wallstrom over the line, left it for Pajot, centers, quick shot, one-timer is turned aside as Parise let it go.
Great save by Grubauer as he took away the bottom half of the net. Got to get it in the toy department there. Jake's got to fire that one up in the top of the net. Great play, though. with Parise and Pageau and Wahlstrom.
Wahlstrom covering in front of the net. The puck lodges in the catching glove of Grubauer, and there's no further play.
The Islanders are able to break out of their own end, finally with a little speed and a little three-on-three. And shot from the point, a little bounce here and there, so you can see the Kraken all coming back rather slow. They look tired, little drop pass, and Pageau finds Parise hollow. That's the P&P, but look where that shot is. It's a really good save, don't get me wrong, but when those goalies come across, Jakes, they're taking away the bottom half of the net. You've got to get that puck up. Keep saying it. Don't shoot it low when on those seam passes. Let it go up there.
And that was just a half, Brendan.
Yeah, I caught myself.
Yeah, you did. Well done. You know, a lot of people are exchanging money now. How long it would be before?
Yeah, well, it's, you know, well into the second.
And again, Larson holding the puck at the point. Right back to him. Right-handed shot defenseman, and the shot blocked in front of the net.
At least you haven't called me Eddie yet. Number 18.
Okay, 91. Pelicans dumped it in. The Islanders changing the defense combination. Green out here on the left side, joined by Pulock over on the right. Seattle content to dump it in and give chase. Now they're in the middle of a change. And the Islanders, Zach Parise over center, across the line. Three men back and he can't get through. Anders Lee knocked it loose, unable to recover. And the Kraken are away. Three on three at the Islander line. A little dipsy doodle, and that didn't work.
Little game of one-on-one, and that's not going to work all that often.
Ryan Donato, he's in front of the net after the rebound, and it's cleared away.
Good play by Donskoy there to let that shot go.
Just earlier on, Barzal trying to take on both defensemen, and that's Barry Trotz talks about that all the time. And you know, he talks about it with Wahlstrom and with Barzal. Is, you know, this one-on-one game, trying to beat people at this level, really difficult. And the Islanders have been very, very sloppy over the last 5 minutes, Jake. So a lot of turnovers.
Is it the wear and tear of 3 and 4 night? Yet the same can be said for Seattle.
Could be a little bit of the mental tiredness, Jakes, and not necessarily because they look to me like they're skating all right. They're working hard, but you know, or you know, sometimes when you get nothing, 0-0 games, you get impatient, and the team that gets impatient usually makes mistakes.
Carl Palmieri had to reach back, and in reaching back, Appleton tumbled to the ice. No problem, and the Islanders able to clear it deep into the Seattle end, and now they complete some player changes. This is Appleton on the right side. That dump in allows Seattle to complete their player changes. Sedano Chara up the right wing boards. The Islanders don't get it out. Now Chara chips it to Beauvillier. Anthony Beauvillier crossed the line, unable to work the puck to Nelson. And a second time it got away from Nelson. And Geeky starts the rush the other direction and goes in on the forecheck. Ian Dobson, the puck loose at the side of the Islander net. Kraken, the first to get to it, as Blackwell plays it toward Geeky. To Blackwell at the side of the net, had trouble handling it. Now works it back, and a shot from the point is steered aside. Geeky works it to the blue line. Larson open here on the right side, takes the feed. Into the high slot, fires one that's blocked. Never did get to the net.
Tired group out there for the Islanders. And Brock Nelson does the smart thing. That and an even smarter play right there, just to chip it in behind the net. And the Islanders will make a wholesale change.
Got it in deep without an icing call. And Eberle is back the other direction. Just dumped it to the corner. The Islanders give chase. Bullock turned it up the right wing boards. On they come with Pageau, a dump in. Green open here at the left point. Instead, it goes to Pulock for a shot. This twied by a fraction. Islanders regain control momentarily. Eberle gets checked by Wahlstrom, but the Kraken able to feed Jordan Eberle. Little give and go. Quick shot off the far side. And bouncing off the boards, and the Islanders get to center ice, but Barzal is unable to pick it up.
Nice setup there with Jordan Eberle over to McCann, and he just whistled that one wide.
And that was Pageau, not Barzal a moment ago. My apologies. 2:22 left in the second period. Deuces Wild, the second day of February. The Oilers. Live coverage begins at 8:30 Eastern with Islanders game night, and the puck drop is at 9 o'clock Eastern, February 11th on MSG Plus. The game presented by Mount Sinai South Nassau, or stream it on MSG Go. A couple of games in between, but you guys aren't going west, huh?
No, we are not. We'll watch. Brendan Noe, I think, is doing one of the games out west. But I'll be holidaying, Diggs.
Nothing different about that, is there?
No. Well, the Islanders need to find a way to score a goal in these last couple of minutes.
Yeah, it'd be nice to get out of the opening, out of the second period at least, with a goal lead going to the third. The Seattle team has won 5 games away from home this season.
Well, they play hard. They've got good legs. They've got some youth.
And they've surprised some pretty good teams.
And the Islanders are, for me, it's like the biorhythms are off just a little bit. The work's there, but the coordination isn't quite there. It's just like pucks bouncing or they're mishandling it.
Donskoy had it taken away. Zigging and zagging is Matt Barzal to the blue line. Dobson shot off a body and wide.
That hit Chara. He was trying to get out of the way of Barzal.
Now a misfire. Bailey in on the check of his man. Barzal ends up with the puck. Over to Dobson.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, man.
Just missed the pass with Anders Lee in an empty net. That's why I say the biorhythms are off just a little bit, where the passes that normally would be right on the stick. That's all it takes, a game of inches.
Into the final minute of period two. Chara flips one up into the center ice area, knocked down by Fleury. And an Appleton shot. Handled, no problem. See you. 47 seconds left in the period.
Well, Barzal was trying to do his thing, create a little time and space as he gets inside the blue line, circling back and forth, and finally gets it across. There's Czar, Chara in the right in the slot area. He's just trying to get out of the way of Barzal. You can see number 33. I think it's going to go right off his, not one off, excuse me, off the Kraken skate as he's able to block it. So good job by Wenberg. Thought it hit the big Z. He's got long legs. He can go from board to board.
Yeah, the big Z, as you refer to it, the 6'9", 44-year-old.
Soon to be 45.
Yes, not far away, is it?
No.
Half a minute remaining in the second period. Nothing at the UBS Arena on a Wednesday night. This game rescheduled from last weekend after the snowstorm here on Long Island. The faceoff will come all the way back into the Seattle end of the ice.
I'll see if Barry Trotz wants to make a change, though. He does have Brock Nelson out there, who's good on the faceoffs, but Barry decides to go with a little different line. Pajot, maybe the best centerman that the Isles have. And Pajot, I'm sure, will go to the right-hand corner. He'll go to his backhand. Your backhand's your strongest side, Jiggs, and they all turn that right hand or their left hand, depending on which side of the faceoff they're on, for a little more strength. But that's a good win by Gord.
The Islanders, well, cross ice at the point. Pulock wasn't there, and it came outside the line anyway. Final 10 seconds to tick off. Parise on the left wing boards. Pajot with a shot. That drifted wide on a deflection, and that'll do it. Second period is written into the books, and it's still just the way it started at the beginning of the game, shortly after 7 o'clock tonight. Nothing.
And both goaltenders have been good. I mean, they haven't had to be spectacular. It hasn't been a lot of shots, although the Kraken are out shooting the Islanders 20-11. But I like the way Varlamov has played. He's much more in control tonight, Jakes, and he's more aggressive. I felt like he's been caught in his net a few times over the last 6 or 7 games, but he seems a lot more settled in his appearance. And 2 periods, as you mentioned, no score. The Islanders, as we used to say a long time ago, Jakes, win them in a game.
Yes, indeed. The goaltender has turned aside 20 Seattle shots, and coming up, It's the second period intermission report brought to you by your local Ford stores. Visit buyfordnow.com today. J.G. Pageau will chat with Shannon, then the plays of the month of January. That's all ahead on the Ford intermission report coming up from the UBS Arena. After 40, Islanders nothing, Seattle Kraken nothing. It's up for grabs in the third.
Islanders and Kraken going back and forth on Long Island tonight. And so far, 40 minutes to play. It's still 0-0, but we had a chance to catch up with 44 as he was coming off the ice. AG, thanks so much for your time. When you have three games in four nights, what is important to focus on detail-wise heading into a third period, 0-0?
Yeah, I think you just have to trust the system. Mentally you're tired, physically you're tired, so you just got to stay on top and make sure you pay attention to all the little details, all the one-on-one battles you want to win. And I think at this point, 0-0, Varley made a great job keeping us at zero. So we're going to come back in the third, put a lot of pucks on net with traffic.
First time facing the Seattle Kraken, the newest expansion franchise out there. What's been the biggest challenge with them through 40?
They play well. They're all players that we've played against, that we know. They work hard and they compete. So you have to outwork them if you have a chance to win.
All right, JG, thanks so much for your time. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you.
We're taking a quick break here on the Ford Intermission Report. More to come, including a look back at the best of the best for the month of January. The plays of the month for the Islanders is coming your way next. Islanders and Kraken, neither team have scored a goal through 40 minutes of play, but we do have some pretty goals to show you. They just happen to be coming all from the Islanders and all from the month of January. Let's count them down from 10-1, the top goals of the month of January. At number 10, Robin puts one in the nest.
Here's Barzal looking, dangling, finding Salo, score! There it is! Barzal finding his man, Robin Salo, who gets his first, and the Isles lead 1-0.
Number 9, Ross scores without much of a fight.
Ross Johnson on a breakaway, scores! Ross Johnston, and the Isles get it right back.
At number 8, the Isles are high flyers.
Here's Barzal picking up speed. Barzal blows past McEwen. Barzal, they score! Barzal to Lee on the 2-on-1, and it's tied. Nelson ahead, 1-on-2. Nelson gains the line behind his back for Beauvillier. Parisi scores!
Number 7, Cizikas is on the case.
Trying to provide some offense. Throw it towards the net. There it is again! Casey Cizikas! What a redirection goal! And he's tied the game with 4:28 to go.
At number 6, Austin was on the prowl versus the Coyotes.
A little deeper for Barzal, trying to shake past Chychrun. Barzal got top side, still along the perimeter. Seen pass Mayfield. Net score! What a feed from Scott Mayfield. Zarnik to the back of the net. 2-0 Isles in a hurry.
Number 5, Matt B. Devils, New Jersey.
Barzal scores! Josh Bailey feeds Matt Barzal. Islanders take back the lead in the final 5.
Number 4, Wally's walk-off winner.
This could be special. Oliver Wahlstrom. Score! Winner, winner!
No way!
Donut dinner. Oliver Wahlstrom in the 9th round. His snipe gives the Islanders the extra point.
At 3, Zach attacks the Leafs.
Alley pass to center. Knocked down by Parisi. Drives up the Leafs. Scores! To chip it up over Peter Mrazek.
In at number 2, we get a little wild.
Barzal
Dobson loads and shoots, save, main rebound, free, they score! A diving effort by Oliver Wahlstrom, a power play goal.
And number one, Noah rings in the new year.
And he beats Noah Dobson. Dobson shoots, score!
That smile and celebration from Noah Dobson never gets old to watch. We would love to see some hugs and high fives like that in the third period as the Islanders are looking to close this one out against the Seattle Kraken. We'll be right back.
We find a way. Islanders nothing, Kraken nothing, looking ahead to the third period. And here is our hashtag Cadillac trivia answer. Can you stump us, the experts? Tweet your own questions to hashtag Cadillac Trivia. First goal in Kraken history. I said he's playing in the game tonight. They haven't retired his jersey. The Boston native, right. Ryan Donato.
Yeah, you had that one, Jiggs. I'll give you credit.
Thank you. Well, this, you know.
Once in a while, blind squirrel finds a nut.
There's Ryan. Boston Bruin alum, if you will. I won't go back to the Harvard story, I promise.
Well, it's an opportunity for him to build on his career.
Islanders won the opening draw. Pelech hard around the boards. Mayfield is on the right side of the defense. They get it back to Scott Mayfield. Cross ice. Pelech steps into one. That's blocked. Eberle reaching for it. Gets a stick on it now. And leads a three-on-two rush. Three-on-three is the Islanders. Clutterbuck got back in a hurry. Loose puck in front of the Islander net, recovered and fed off the boards. And brought right back by Cal Clutterbuck.
Good back-checking pressure by McCann forced Clutterbuck to throw it in.
The Islanders got to play, in my opinion, this third period's got to be a straightforward game. And what I mean by that, Jiggs, is no twisting and turning at the blue lines. Keep the puck either. Make sure you get it out of your own zone or get it into the offensive zone. But too many turnovers and giveaways for the Islanders and through the first two periods.
Yeah, just not Islanders hockey tonight, is it?
No, it really isn't. And that has a lot to do with the mind. You said three games in four nights.
And facing an expansion team. And here's Pageau moving in. Shoots. Big stop by Grubauer. Probably the best scoring chance the Islanders have had tonight.
Yeah, a good decision making. They came up with speed and Wallstrom a little chip pass in the neutral zone, and that's what I'm talking about, a straight ahead game. Marley gets a little chip pass and goes up the boards, and Wallstrom gets checked, but Pageau with good speed and creates a little opening and then just kind of lost his angle a little bit. Knows he has to get to the outside, but then he doesn't have much to shoot at, and Grubauer has great patience, didn't go down too early.
The Islanders with Brock Nelson, Kyle Palmieri, Anthony Beauvillier is their forward line at the moment. The Wenberg is over the Islander line here on left wing. Put one in front, that's steered aside. The Islanders trying to get out of the zone, could not. Palmieri finally got it into the center ice area. Beauvillier went in on the forecheck. The Kraken drop it back and start out with Giordano quarterbacking the play, and that forced Andy Green to go back. They jam up on the left wing boards and the puck loose at center ice. Both teams in the middle of changes. Kuzan backing deeper into his own zone. Kuzan came out of the Boston organization to join Seattle. Now an icing call against the New York Islanders. Well, yesterday marked the 29th anniversary of Mr. Gary Bettman as commissioner of the National Hockey League. And you look at the Islander coach who's worked under Mr. Bettman's administration for a long time now, 29 years, February 1st, 93, the Long Island native.
And he's done a remarkable job in bringing hockey to people all over the world, and certainly making the franchises worth a whole lot more money.
Not the easiest job in the world, though, to satisfy now 32 owners.
No, that's exactly right, but he continues to work at it. Says he enjoys it, doesn't have any plans to retire.
I wonder if he's staying up at night worrying about the team in the desert, the Coyotes, and where they're going to play. Hearing tonight that the folks in Tempe say, no, you're not building an arena here.
That's a franchise that seems to have its problems all too regular.
Well, every good parent has one child, I guess, too.
Guess that's a way of
keep them up at night.
Turnover by a young Geeky. And that's something he'll learn that's not really part of the game.
So Zika's moved in with a shot. Zika's from back of the net. Fed it to the blue line. Scott Mayfield, cross ice. Long shot off the end boards. The Kraken move it up left wing. Didn't get it out. Here's Mayfield with a drive. Deflected and off the glass. It stays in play.
Scott Mayfield showing great patience at that blue line. Took a long look to see who he might be able to give the puck to. Showing an awful lot of poise over these last three, four games. And displaying a lot more confidence, seemingly, with the puck.
And a great pass last night.
Two great passes, Jiggs, and one to Barzal and one to his partner, Pellick.
So they've changed up the D, and now it stops and moving it in deep. Pageau works the end boards. Got his man turned around. Wahlstrom fishing for the puck. Knocked away from him, however. And the Kraken move it to center. That's off Gord's stick and right to the goaltender, Varlamov. Kraken looking for their 22nd shot on goal, and they got it off the right shoulder of Varlamov.
Yeah, a little bit of a screen there as Yankov let that one go pretty well.
Thompson got only to center ice, but the puck did end up back in the Kraken zone. And the captain, Giordano, gets it right back again. Looked at Wennberg here on the left side, then decided to reverse the play. So they'll try to come out on the right wing and back to Giordano. Off Donato's stick. Amateurs bank it to the right wing boards. Brock Nelson with a dump in. Islanders avoid any icing call. Palmieri lugs it back in the net. Fed it to Brock Nelson. Top of the near circle. Nelson looks for a man. Quite a cross ice pass that's deflected. And Larson comes to center and over the Islander line with it. Fed it to the left. Donato's shot is denied. The puck was loose for a moment. Ryan Donato checked on the near boards. Good forecheck being thrown up for the moment by Seattle, but finally Brock Nelson is able to clear it. Palmieri tumbled to the deck, as you saw, and the puck ends up deep in the Seattle end.
Yeah, it got stuck in his feet. That last opportunity for the Kraken, where Lazan read the rush, or talk about the offense getting involved in the defense.
Now they're right back into the Islander end where the play is broken up, and Barzal is away on right wing. Couldn't make the pass, however. Now they shoot it down into the Islander end, a race for it. Pellick steps in front of his man. The man happens to be Johansson. And they score off the far side. Once again, the Islanders give up the first goal of the game, but not in the first minute of the contest.
Now the puck came bouncing out, and on the short side was that man McCann, who, and it's just a chip and chase play, and one-on-one down in the corner with Johansson, and then Jordan Eberle, he's the one that's able to get the puck on the short side, and Varlamov just can't react quick enough to get on the other side. You can see the pass out there, and then Varlamov's just, he's not in position to be able to make that save, so it's Jordan Eberle who makes a really good play in behind the net, and the Islanders don't have tight enough coverage on their three-on-three play down low, and the Islanders are down a goal.
McCann's 19th of the season at 6:04, a career high in goals for Jordan McCann. Comes at the 6:04 mark of the third period on home ice, the Islanders trail. And the Kraken picking up the pace here, shot right into the glove up at the top of the blue paint, is Varlamov to make the stop. But the Islanders are down 1-0 to the visitors, the expansion team from Seattle, the Kraken. A little scuffling, pushing and shoving. Tempers flaring a little, but they'll settle down and we'll be right back. Full replay.
Good hard work in the corner as Jordan Eberle kind of wins that battle with Mayfield and just chips it out, and Varlamov's not able to track it. It's right in behind him, so he's not sure which way to look. Normally, goaltenders take one side of the net or the other side, Jigs, and they look over the opposite shoulder. Varlamov was in the middle of the net and obviously didn't know where that puck was. Came out on the short side, and sharpshooter Jarrett McCann is able to push it off the left shoulder of Varlamov.
Jordan Eberle picks up a point on the go-ahead goal. Along with Johansson. Came at 6:04 of this third period. Islanders winning the draw in their own zone as Martin nudged it back in the net. Cal Clutterbuck flips one out to center. Martin gets over the line and his shot on goal is turned aside by Grubauer. Fleury moving it up the left side down into the Islander end. Pulott lost his balance as he tried to turn here. The Kraken center one in front. Came off the far boards. Cizikas to Martin into the zone. Then the Islanders in the middle of the change, and the long pass didn't connect with Geeky. Pageau is over the line. Pageau unable to center it cleanly. Loose puck. Islanders get to it on the near boards. Wahlstrom couldn't get a shot away, and he'll have to hustle back for it.
Yeah, not enough shots. I mean, you got to throw the puck. You got guys going towards the net, and Pageau trying to make a pass through about three, four legs.
Now across ice at their own blue line, partially deflected. And then recovered and dumped down, and the Islanders are going for a change. Pageau in on the forecheck. Parisi there as well. Parisi thought he had Pageau open. He did, but it's not long enough to gain control of the puck. This is Noah Dobson. Dobson and Palmieri unable to team up. Well, the Kraken got a long pass for Donato. Too far, icing called against the Kraken.
Islanders have tried to pick up their pace a little bit. Still not getting a whole lot done. And again, I'm reluctant to, when you're down a goal, Jigs, and you're not getting a lot of opportunities, you got to throw the puck towards the net, in my opinion. And the Islanders still looking for those plays, those pretty plays. Get the puck going towards the net, force the goalie to make a save. A lot of rebounds, potential for rebounds and stuff.
Brock Nelson and McCann on that faceoff, and McCann lost his helmet and had to go right to the bench. There's a drive off the right side that went way wide. The Islanders with a bit of a scramble in front, unable to regain control of the puck. This is Ryan Donato, cross ice pass. They're on side, big drive, big rebound off Varlamov. Islanders at center. Brock Nelson's cross ice pass is picked off. Still 11 and a half minutes remaining in regulation as Appleton turns here on the left wing boards. Fed it to the blue line. A backhander, they score! 2-0 Seattle as Vince Dunn took a perfect pass and beats Varlamov.
Yeah, he had the puck in the top of the blue line and just the seas parted for him and ended up going on the backhand. Not sure if Varlamov was screened or not. And now the Kraken have jumped out in front. 2-0 and a little stop and go action as Appleton drops it back, a little fake pass. And on the other, he's definitely screened as Gord was in front of him. I don't think Varlamov ever saw the puck. You can see him standing right in front, doesn't pick it up quick enough, and it gets past the lower glove hand of Varlamov. Kraken have struck for a couple of goals in this third period. Still plenty of time, but now the Islanders have dug themselves a hole.
Yeah, the goals come 2 minutes, 31 seconds apart. McCann with his 19th, and now Vince Dunn, the defenseman, has his fifth of the season. Eberle, without a goal in his last 20, lost his balance. The puck as well, but Josh Bailey can't get it away from Eberle.
Well, you know, Jordan Eberle's got to be feeling pretty good about this game, and even though he hasn't scored, he's gotten an assist on that important first goal.
Kraken rattled it around the right wing boards, and they come up 2-on-2 at the Islander blue line. That shot just went wide, and now Fleury off the left point, the older of the two brothers, Hayden Fleury. Hayden is number 4. Kale with the puck there, number 8.
Well, they got a lot of jump now, don't they? The Kraken, and that happens. You get a lead and you're down in the last 10 minutes of a period and got a chance to win. You're not a tired person. Now the Islanders have to dig down and they have to find some energy, and
especially on the road for the Seattle team. They played well against the Rangers on Sunday. Had a great third period in Boston last night. And after 40 minutes of scoreless hockey, have taken a 2-0 lead against the home team New York Islanders.
And they're all over the Islanders right now. And they're reeling.
Lead pass just out of the reach. The on-rushing Cizikas, and back the other way. Geeky with a feed. Blackwell with a shot. Loose puck in front and snagging that and holding on is Varlamov. Islanders down by 2 with 9.5 minutes remaining in regulation time on home ice.
We're pushed off the puck, and that man there, tough angle shot, but able to bounce it in, and the leading goal scorer for the Seattle Kraken, Jared McCann, comes through.
29 points on the season now for McCann. The Seattle team won their second road game at the beginning of the season, beating Nashville. And they beat the Florida Panthers by a score of 4-1 in Florida. Beat Buffalo, won at San Jose, and in overtime knocked off the Pittsburgh Penguins. That was the 27th of January. So looking for their 6th road win. And at 9 minutes to protect this lead. Wahlstrom over the line, trying to get one in front, did. It dribbled through to the 8th blue ice and covered by Grubauer. Islanders season tickets sold out for the inaugural season here at UBS Arena. But you can place your deposit today to get first in line for access to the 2022-23 season. Deposit holders also receive special benefits, including pre-sale access to concerts held here at UBS Arena. Here's what you do to place your deposit. Visit NewYorkIslanders.com/deposit.
Little change in the line here. Bailey now playing with Beauvillier and Nelson. So Coach Trotz trying to find something that gets the puck in the net for him. There just hasn't been a whole lot of what I would call chemistry to this game for the Islanders. So the effort has been okay. Kraken certainly have a few more legs than this period thus far than the Islanders, but they're just very disjointed effort so far, and the fans are not happy, Jiggs.
Yeah, the Seattle Kraken have outshot the Islanders 8-4 here in the third period and scored twice.
28-15 on the night, and that's a pretty good indication really of the game as far as you know, the offensive prowess or lack of for the Islanders. There's been nothing going on in that direction. They're missing passes and not taking shots when they could be, and taking shots when they shouldn't be, and it's a little disjointed.
Yeah, disjointed is right. Let me correct something I mentioned earlier, that McCann now at a career high 19 goals. He's matched his career high at 19 in the 2018-19 season. That was the year that he was traded from the Florida Panthers to Pittsburgh. He had 8 with the Panthers, another 11 with the Penguins. So he has matched that through the first half of the season with his expansion, Seattle Kraken.
Yeah, he get a little more ice time and a little bit better. Some good players to play with, play on the power play and such. Those are scenarios that are going to help you statistically.
And it just may lead to somebody saying, yeah, that's the guy we want for a playoff run. And Seattle picks up the draft pick. That's the way Ron Francis reportedly wants to build his franchise. Not, look out. Yanni Gord, fed it off. Opportunity to shoot, elected to pass instead, and back come the Islanders.
I don't know why Barzal didn't move that one in a hurry inside the blue line. He had a winger going right to the net. I believe it was Parise at the top of the blue line. He was wide open, and Matt elected to seek something better. It's almost like a quarterback, Brendan.
Yes,
Jake. It's almost like a quarterback. It's just like, oh, I got a wide open receiver. Let me see if I can get the home run. And more often than not, that doesn't work out.
J.G. Pageot to Chara. Chara works it around the boards. His teammates were in the midst of a change. Adam Pellick off the right side. His shot drifted wide. Parise unable to get control of it. And the Kraken will come to center ice. Gord is over the line. Let's one go. Off by Lamov. Rebound was there and chipped wide to the Islanders' net. Kraken get it back to the blue line for Giordano. Mark Giordano, the 38-year-old captain of the Seattle team, led all the defensemen in ice time through 40 minutes. Led again last night in Boston, too.
Well, I'll tell you what, the way Giordano and Larson have played tonight, there's going to be some interesting people, interested parties, and adding those guys to their team. They have been solid. And I'll tell you what, you take them as your 5-6 defensemen, you've improved your hockey team.
Their first-round draft pick is a young man who is playing at the University of Michigan. And if you're going to watch the Olympics in the next couple of weeks, he will be on the U.S. squad. His name is Matty Beniers. They say he's much like the general manager of this Seattle team, plays the same way as Ron Francis did.
Well, that's hard, that's for sure. Good two-way center, Ronnie Francis. Good on faceoffs.
5 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the third period on home ice. The Islanders down by two.
And they're in trouble of getting below that 500 mark again, Jiggs. They just got above it the one game. And
Kraken over the line, two on one, centering pass, and oh, just off the target.
Sheehan with the second time this period has had a great opportunity to score.
Hasn't seen a whole lot of ice time, but it's been effective when out there.
Good legs then, I guess. He's not tired.
Sheehan out of St. Catharines, Ontario. Went to Notre Dame. Long shot from the blue line. Blocked on the way to the net. And the Islanders have cleared it all the way down. And this will be an icing call against New York.
Fans very frustrated, Jake. I'm in there. Such high expectations this season, and as you mentioned earlier on, there are no season tickets available for this entire season, and everybody expected this to be a long season and playoffs and such, and certainly does not look like that's going to happen. And the Islanders just have not been able to find a way to score tonight, which has been pretty much their IO, the entire season.
Yeah, you saw Barry Trotz a moment ago, 1,769 games behind the bench as of tonight. So he, I'm sure one or two of those games he's seen either Nashville, Washington, and certainly now the Islanders just kind of stripped their gears.
Yeah, I'm sure the coach is very, very frustrated. And you know, last two outings, the six periods of maybe the best six periods of hockey they've had all season long, and then they can't seem to get anything done against this Seattle team, who have skated extremely well and checked really well. They've been a relentless group of players.
Well, the Baby Islanders, the Bridgeport Islanders, had a game this morning across the Sound, and they beat the Lehigh Valley Club by a score of 4-1. Simon Holstrom, Andy Andreoff, Eric Brown, and Jeff Kubiak with the goals. Corey Schneider was in the net, by the way. He gave up the one goal. 4-1 Bridgeport win. This must have been the morning that they have the school kids out, right?
Yes.
Now 3 minutes remaining in the third. And Grubauer pitching a shutout against the Islanders. But has faced only 16 shots, and Dobson gave it up at the blue line. Here's a partial break. Donato picks it up, comes right in, backhander up for Varlamov.
Great save there by Varlamov. Just read him like an open book. Islanders got caught in a change.
Dunn, who has the second goal, the defenseman just dumped it into the far corner, came right out in front and fired wide.
This has been a really tough period for the Islanders. They've been completely outplayed in this third period. Kraken have outskated them. The Islanders have lost their legs.
And Seattle really has the Islanders tied up and running around in their own end of the ice here. And the Bluebirds off the roost. Matt Martin had his pocket picked.
Now they're tired. Well, that should have been a penalty by Lozon, as he.
I think so.
He cross-checked him, and he wasn't anywhere near the play. And then there goes Varlamov off the ice. And the Islanders 6-on-5 are going to see if they can't find a way to close the gap, make a last-ditch effort to win the game.
Fed back to Noah Dobson, then cross ice. Barzal looking for somebody to give it to. Fired toward the net. Pad save. Hartzell reaching for it in the corner. Pageot turns it around the boards. Wallstrom on right wing puts one in front under Grubauer and no further play.
Grubauer didn't even know he had it. The right play by Wallstrom. Get it towards the net. Anders Lee was there. And Grubauer's having one of those games where you don't have to always see it. You just have to be in the right position. There he is. He starts to get away from the post. He got a little bit lucky. Donato with a breakaway and kind of went off the end of his stick. Barry Trotz will talk it over with his team and assistant coach.
This timeout is brought to you by your local Honda dealers. Visit one today.
Just going to say, Jakes, that John Gruden, the assistant coach, is discussing the 6-on-5. Islanders have been pretty successful over the. They've had plenty of opportunities really over the last while of being down a couple of goals in this third period, and see if they can come up with some magic. They need to pull a rabbit out of their hat. And that's coach, assistant coach Jay Leach, I believe, is talking to his team and the defensive coach specialist, I would assume. And now you put your best defensive five best defensive people out there. Yanni Gord was a good defensive specialist for the Tampa Bay Lightning and very good on faceoffs.
Ian Pageot on the draw. And the Kraken able to pick it up, banked off the glass and down. Icing, another faceoff coming up.
Yeah, that was I would give Pageot the win. The puck was just on his side, but Lozon was able to outmuscle Barzal on the near side and ice it down. Doggone near put it over the glass. Diggs had hit up pretty high. That would have been a nice break for the Islanders.
False start on this one. Oop, down goes the linesman. Down goes Barzal. Johnny Gord is picking himself up.
Barzal jumped the gun just a little bit, trying to get ahead of Lozon.
And he is the last man off the mat.
Got to switch centerman now. Barzal, the right-handed, going to have to bear down.
Nudged it deeper into the Seattle zone, and Lozon moved it out the right side and down into the Islander end of the ice. Ronnie Gord was first man in on the forecheck, and that's Dobson working across ice. Into the final minute of Seattle's only visit to the UBS Arena this season and looking for their first shutout victory on the road. Dobson, Nelson, Dobson to the corner and unable to handle it was Wallstrom. Here's Barzal. He can't get it to the front of the net. Dobson faked the shot. Drives down to the icing line, gave it to Barzal to Nelson. Nelson, whose shot was blocked. Here's Dobson. One more chance. Barzal rips one off A stick, I believe, and up out of play.
Well, Islanders with some opportunities, and it's one of those games, Jigs, where you, the goaltender has the better of you, and everything he does is right. You've seen it with Sorokin and Varlamov, and this game here seems to be Grubauer's, as he's really got a good focus going, and Barzal tries to go short side high, and I believe that went off the crossbar or the side of the post. And the Islanders are going to lose this game.
23.6 tenths of a second to some history making for the Seattle Kraken. And Philip Grubauer. Josh Bailey tries to center. Grubauer has it in the catching glove. Put it up against the mesh on the outside of the net to hold on. I guess it's okay to go ahead and say it would be the first shutout in Kraken history.
Well, there's 10 seconds, and there are a lot of people who are Seattle fans would say you would be shooting the duck. But that's okay, Jakes, as far as the Islander fans are concerned.
Philip Grubauer has never shut out a New York Islanders team in his career.
And he's about to.
Yeah, the puck at center ice. And an empty net for a 3-0 Kraken victory.
Appleton, and very selfish play and a very smart play by Blackwell. And the Islanders lose this game. And then this was a game that they're supposed to win and need to win. And there's going to be a lot of disappointment on that bench. And now you got to go into a break, Jigs, and it's not going to be a good feeling for the Islanders. It would have been a much better scenario for them to, albeit they're a long ways behind on the for a playoff spot, but now it's kind of throwing some salt on the wound.
Indeed. Final second ticks off. Appleton's fifth of the season into the empty net. Salts away a 3-0 victory, and Philip Grubauer has his first shutout of the season, 19th career shutout. Seattle Kraken, their first shutout victory in the history of this new franchise.
Yeah, you know what? And they were the better team tonight, Jigs. They skated extremely well. They got off to a real good start, and they battled the Islanders to a zip-zip tie in the first period. And they were consistent. They never slowed down, never lost a stride. And they hung right in there with the Islanders. And listen, give them credit from a defensive standpoint. The Islanders only had 19 shots on net, a couple near the end, and not a lot of great scoring opportunities. This was a pretty easy game, relatively speaking, for Grubauer, you know, and earning an assist. So, like I said, that's going to be a disappointed hockey team across the way from us.
Season low, 19 shots on goal for the New York Islanders.